is the Holy Spirit plain. We have a burning desire to lift up Jesus' name.
Welcome to this service at Faith and Victory Church. This is the place to come to receive your miracle from God. Now, let's join our service already in progress.
Let's go back to last week. We were in John 4, verse 14. Jesus speaking and says this, "But whoso drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life." Hallelujah. Everlasting life. Amen. And as we're saying last week, excuse me, this is the new birth. Jesus, when he came into the earth, and he spoke in reference to the well of life, this is where the believer is to live from. We are to live from the well of life that springs up in us. Now, we being Pentecostal, charismatic, word of faith, you know, Bible-toting, tongue-talking, devil-casting-out believers, you know, we like to... You know, we emphasize the baptism of the Holy Spirit, and there's a place for that. But the believer must first learn that we live from the well that springs up, out of the new birth. That's where that life is springing up in us, and that is for us to live from. That's where you live. You live from the well of life. Amen? That's what springs up in you on a regular basis. Why? Because Jesus came to give you everlasting life, and that's a well. It's the well of life. We live in the life that now is, amen, and that which is to come, glory to God. Can you say amen? And that life on the inside of us is how we live. We live out of that life. Somebody say, thank God for the life. Three of you. How about the rest of you? Thank God for the life. Amen. Now, if you're trying to watch this on the internet at the same time because you're excited we're live, it's a delay. It's probably about a 10 or 15 second delay. All right, just so you're wondering why it looks like a... So that way, now, if you miss something, look at your phone real quick. You can get what you missed. Hallelujah. All right, so Jesus said that, you know, he'll give us you'll never thirst. See, we're to be satisfied. Our life is to be satisfied with our relationship with God. Amen. Now, you got a lot of people. We got all kinds. How many ever seen one of these? All right, well, when the church moved, we went to a cyberspace phone line that rang to my house. We never knew if it was the church or if it was the house phone. So we just got a little flip phone this week. Well, that's the office. There, that is the offices of Faith and Victory Church right there. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. All right. We've got so many people who are not satisfied. Christians who aren't satisfied. They got to run from this. And I'm going to tell you something. I grew up classical Pentecostal. Came over among the charismatics and the Word of Faith move. And I want to tell you, we were some of the most dissatisfied people on the planet. Supposed to be satisfied. Why? Always running from church to church, from meeting to meeting. It had to be some kind of move going on. We couldn't live on a daily, consistent basis and be satisfied as a general rule. When we missed it. The baptism of the Holy Spirit has a role and a place in our life as a believer, but we must learn first that we are to live from the well that springs up on the inside. Amen? That's where we drink of those waters. We drink of those waters on a daily basis. We drink of those waters as we rise, as we lie down, as we in the middle of the day. Those waters of life are where we're to drink from. The new birth should bring satisfaction to your heart. I said the new birth should bring satisfaction to your heart. There should be such a joy. Hallelujah, that you're born again, that you pass from death unto life, that the nature of the Father has been imparted unto you. Thank you, Melanie. Praise the Lord. That the nature of the Father has been imparted unto you, glory to God. You now live from a well life source that continually flows on the inside, praise God. Can somebody shout glory that Jesus is your Lord, hallelujah, that the Father God's now your Father, praise God, that you're an heir of God and a joint heir with Jesus Christ, that you've been made the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus, glory to God. Can you shout hallelujah? Can you shout amen? But I'll tell you, sometimes we get to a certain point, and because we're not getting tickled, and we're not getting thrilled, and we're kind of like James Brown. Oh, the thrill is gone. You know, we're kind of running around with no thrill anymore. I want you to know every day should be a joyous day. It's joy unspeakable and full of glory. Can you shout hallelujah? What are you talking about? I'm just talking about the new birth. Being born again, hallelujah. Coming into harmony with the Father, praise God. And I was better preaching than you're shouting. I didn't see anybody running. I didn't hear one single, help me, Jesus, hallelujah. There's a life on the inside of you this morning, praise God. That when you face the trials and the temptations of life, praise God, when you come against all the forces of darkness, on the inside of you there is a life, hallelujah, that springs up, and we drink from that well. And in the midst of the deserts and the storms of life, we have a continual source to drink from, and it's the life of God, hallelujah. Can somebody else shout glory? And so the satisfaction of life should not be found. We got to get to this meeting and get the hottest, newest, latest, heavy revy. I thank God that God emphasizes things in the body of Christ to bring revelation to us or to reinforce something in our lives. But I am telling you, you have got to come to the place that you can drink from that well and have satisfaction in your heart. That being with Jesus, having that life on the inside of you, you don't need the external stimulation of the world. You don't have to be like the world. You don't have to put on a show like the world to act like you're excited about something. But you've come and you've drank from the well that the Master has provided. And there is a well that springs up in you today. Glory to God. I say glory to God, glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. And that well of life, that well of water springing up, brings satisfaction to the heart of the believer. Amen. We're living in a time where we have to bring the external in to get believers to believe that they're content. Oh, my brothers, my sister, go back and drink from the well. I said, go back and drink of Jesus. Hallelujah. Just having a love relationship with the Lord. Amen. I said amen. Where intimacy with God brings you greater peace and greater satisfaction and greater joy than anything this world could ever muster up. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Well, what are you saying? We don't need the Holy Ghost. Just hold on to your seats. See, Jesus in John 4 said that he said there's going to be a well that springs up. Can you say amen? That life is continually in you. When you get up and I feel like, you're like you're going to try out for Hee-Haw. You're doing your own personal Hee-Haw remake. Gloom, despair, and agony on me. Deep, dark depression, excessive misery. If it weren't for bad luck, I'd have no luck at all. Gloom, despair, and agony on me. Wouldn't that put faith in you? How about, where are you tonight? Why did you leave me here all alone? I searched the world over, thought I found true love. You met another, and you was gone. You ever woke up and felt like that? Well, let me ask you, in the natural, do you ever wake up in the morning with a dry throat? What do? You go get some water. You ever wake up spiritually dry? What do? You go get some water. I said, you go get some water. That well's springing. Listen, this is the good thing. You only have to go prime the pump. Some of y'all may know what I'm talking about now. You always kept a little jug of water beside the pump on the back porch. Go in there and pour some in. Start doing like this as you're pouring it in so it starts siphoning. And the next thing you know, after a minute, and that water was rusty when it first came out. Because the pipe got rusty. You had to get enough water coming through to get rid of that taste. But then when it got that was cold water. That water's down there underground. That's cold water. But you had to prime the pump. Jesus said it's a spring. See, with a spring, you don't have to prime a pump. It's just pumping up. It's just flowing up. My father-in-law has, my in-laws have a cabin up in the mountains. And they're on a combined water system, but it's off a spring. The water pressure is not, there's no electricity behind the water pressure. They just have a tank that holds extra water. It's all pressurized from the spring. Boy, it'll exfoliate you in the shower. I mean, it comes out with such pressure. And see, Jesus said his life is going to be a well that springs up. It's always flowing. You can always come to the water and drink. It's always there. It's always fresh. It's always ready. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. And so, you know, that last week we were talking about this, and we're kind of wrapping that up. Now let's talk about this. So that's for us as a believer. That's for us as an individual. See, the other people don't drink of your water. They don't come to the spring. Say, the spring's for me. The spring's for you. See, it's everlasting life to you. Can you say amen? Glory to God. You're to have that spring. You're to drink out of that spring. That's your life source. Now that we're live on the internet, I can't do some of the things I'm doing like I'm doing right now. Hallelujah. See, if I did some stuff, Brother Bill could edit it. Now that it's live, you can't edit it. Go to John 7. John 7, verse 37. Hallelujah. In the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, "If any man thirst, let him come to me and drink. He that believeth in me, on me, as the scripture hath said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water." Well, which is it, Pastor? A well or rivers? It's the difference between the new birth and the baptism of the Holy Spirit. This is the difference between the new birth and the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Now, we just shared that the new birth, that well, is for you. That springs up for you to drink out of. It's for you. But out of his belly shall flow rivers of water, living water. But this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive, for the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. See, the baptism of the Holy Spirit is the rivers to humanity from your life. You are to be satisfied with or without glory bumps. You're to be consistent with or without Holy Ghost meetings. You're to be satisfied whether you got, it's a 5-year lull between the hottest revelation. This is why we have been so susceptible to false doctrines and false teaching or excessive teachings. We weren't living out of the well. We were trying to live in the rivers. And the rivers were for other people. Can I get at least a grunt? Holy grunt, at least. A holy grunt. You see, we got so up to the point where we had to have something so exciting all the time. Are you here? They weren't living out of the well. We wanted to live out of the rivers. But the rivers were really for other people to come and to receive the life that we're now drinking out of on a daily basis. Now, I know that, I don't want to, get, so I'm generalizing now. There are purposes of the baptism of the Holy Spirit that help us and aid us, but its main purpose is to reach others. It is to be rivers of water flowing out of you to humanity. Can you say amen? We're so busy running to try to get in rivers when we can stay and drink of the well and be a river. Be filled with the Holy Spirit and be a river. We're not to be chasing rivers. We're to become rivers. Don't take this to the extreme. You need to be in good meetings. You need to be in services where, iron sharpens iron. I get all that. I love good services. Hallelujah. I mean, I love it when we can hang from the chandeliers. I mean, I'm Pentecostal in the heart and the root, and I'm not denying that. What I'm saying is we have to have a different opinion or a different approach to things. So if we haven't been, I remember when I first got saved. Now, there was a group of us that we had this little thing called a cottage prayer meeting. It wasn't in a cottage. It sounded spiritual for some reason. I just say that, cottage prayer meeting. Okay, that sounds spiritual. I didn't know what it was. It was a bunch of us getting together and praying over each other and prophesying over each other, and everybody had a word for everybody. We even had the official prayer chair. Everybody, you had to get in the prayer chair and everybody pray over you. And everybody prophesy over you or say something over you. I'm not sure that was prophecy. Hello? And I remember, you know, I'd gotten saved. I was very young in the Lord. And, you know, some people in the church doing it. And the pastor really wasn't behind it. And they would talk about how he wasn't spiritual. Probably more spiritual than anybody in the room. Hallelujah, because he didn't come and he didn't support it. Well, it's because it was flaky. I mean, you drove up and there's a sign over everything that said, "Welcome to Granola Farms." That's a joke. You know, fruits, nuts, and flakes all packaged together in the same place. Hallelujah. Amen. But I remember, I got saved, and we'd go over there, and every week, you know, you get in the prayer chair. Somebody, the Lord says, they prophesy over you. So what are you trying? You're trying to live in the river. I said, you're trying to live in the river, which is okay to get in the river occasionally when God's moved you that way. You're supposed to be living out of the well. You're supposed to be drinking of the well. We're trying to run over and get in the river and forget the well and let the river do everything the well is supposed to be doing. And we go every week, you know, and you get in there, you know, and you just wait your turn. And boy, if that chair got open for a second, you hopped in and waited for your word. Well, about 6-8 weeks of that, every week, and all of a sudden you realize, I'm not satisfied. Something not right. I went 1 week and didn't get in the chair. I mean, you know, the Antichrist had taken over. The world had come to an end. The rapture took place. You got left behind. They got 666 branding irons waiting, about looking for folks. You know what I mean? It's over. And what had happened was, I had learned to depend on the river and didn't know anything about the well. Oh, thank God for the revelation of the Word. Thank God that, you know, when you get to the right place and the right teaching that can show you how to live out of the river, out of the well, and what the river's for. Praise God, you can grow, hallelujah, and you can become where you don't have to have the prayer chair to get over. I'm glad when I get up in the morning, I don't have to run down the sheets and get a bottle of water to get something to drink. Or run out to the river, you know, down to the deep river and jump in and get something to drink. I don't want to drink out of there anyway. I just go down there and get me some water. Hallelujah. I thank God now as a believer. I don't have to go find a meeting to satisfy my soul, to satisfy my heart. I can drink from the life that springs up. But then I can stay full of the Holy Ghost, and I can be a river of God's love, of God's mercy, of God's healing power, of God's delivering power to humanity that's in need. Amen? I said amen. Hallelujah. Ephesians 5:18 says, "Be not drunk with wine, wherein is excess. But be ye filled," or the Greek says, "be ye being filled," on a continuous basis, "with the Holy Ghost. Not so you can be satisfied, so that you're equipped to minister to others. So that there is a well, that there is a, not a well, but there is a river of resource to humanity that flows." Amen? That you can bring the life-giving, the source of the life-giving power of God to hurting humanity. Too many times we want to get together and have all of our rivers flow into a building and have a meeting, instead of getting out of the building and taking the rivers to the people who need it. If we're going to win the world, we're not going to do it inside the church. We're going to do it outside the church. We're going to come together, and we're going to sharpen one another. Amen? We're going to be restored. We're going to be refreshed together. But we got to take those rivers to humanity. I said, we got to take those rivers to humanity. There have to be rivers of life. Hallelujah. I got a river of life flowing out of me. Makes the lame to walk and the blind to see. Opens prison doors and sets the captives free. I got a river of life flowing out of me. Okay, all right. Going to take next worship service too. Don't be drunk with wine. Oh, the biggest narrative in the church says you can drink. It's okay. Why don't you just stop your stupid drinking and go drink of the water, stay full of the Holy Ghost, and be a river to humanity. You're not helping them sitting at the bar drinking. I'm a liberal Christian. I'm a liberated Christian. I can drink. Hallelujah. So can they. They don't care. They can't get what you got at the bar. They need for you to be bringing rivers of living water. The anointing of God to destroy the yokes of bondage and captivity out of their lives. They don't really care if you like Jack Daniels or you can drink some rum and do it with a good conscience. As a matter of fact, they'll tell you, oh, that's great, you Christian. I didn't know you got kind of Christians that can do all this and be cool. But I can tell you, they're not going to be looking for you when they're dying of cancer. One of the things they said about millennials, you know, we think millennials are so hip and hipster and cutting edge and all this kind of stuff. One of the things they said is they like liturgical church buildings when they go to church. It makes them feel more spiritual. Stained glass windows, folks. The studies show they like stained glass windows. We're doing everything in the world to be like the world, and they want to be more traditional. Why? Because our acting like the world hasn't given them what they're looking for. Our being like the world hasn't given them what they're looking for. Conforming to the world is not giving them what they're looking for. Being a river of life is what they're looking for. They're looking for the life to flow. They're looking for the life to flow. I can tell you that old song, that old rock and roll song. Let the river flow. Like, anyway, remember that Let Your Love Flow? Well, anyway. I forgot who did that. Don't remind me. Hallelujah. Jude 20 says, but ye beloved, build up yourselves in your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. We are to be examples to humanity. We have spent so much time trying to be like humanity, we've given them nothing to look forward to. I'm telling you, when Jesus went and ate with the publicans and sinners, he didn't look like a publican and a sinner. How do you know? They call him Rabboni, Rabbi, teacher. When he died, they cast lots for his clothing. He didn't look like a publican or a sinner. He ate with them, yes, but he wasn't them. He was what they needed. He came to demonstrate what they could have, not what they already were. We're so busy trying to show people we can be like them, there's no vision to be different. And we're supposed to be bringing rivers of living water, not a fifth. Hello? They don't need Bud Light, they need the light. Come on. Are you here? We have got to learn that our satisfaction, it's not, we want people to like us. Jesus talked about us being blessed when all men say all manner of evil against us and all kinds of stuff and all that kind of stuff. Not when they thought you were cool like them. Because see, we are responsible to be bearers and bearers of the light and to bring the rivers of living water to them. You've got to be full of the Holy Ghost. But being full of the Holy Ghost is not so you can go, woo! You know, and we sing it. I love the song. I got it. Something about the Holy Ghost. You know, I got it in my hands. I got it in my feet. I got him all over me. I mean, I love it. But in the end, it's not so you can have a good time. Because if that is the end of your Holy Ghost service, if that is the end of your experience in the baptism of the Holy Spirit, if that is the end of what you're after, you're never going to reach the place you're supposed to be, because you're supposed to be a river of living water to humanity. And in those rivers is the rivers of life. The rivers of healing, the rivers of anointing, the rivers of liberation, the rivers of breaking the power of the devil, the deliverance. There is the rivers of everything that humanity has need of, and it's supposed to be flowing out of you. You're supposed to walk into the place I mean, Wigglesworth would get on a train with an Episcopal priest in England and sat down beside him. And a few minutes later, that man jumped up and said, "My God, man, you convict me of sin," and ran out of that car to another car. He didn't do anything except that the life was just flowing out. Well, he made people feel bad. No, but the light of God will. Peter, when Jesus did, worked the miracle, said, "Depart from me, I'm a sinful man." He said, "I'll make you fishers of men." It wasn't to make him feel bad. It was to bring him to the place. You can't keep going where you're going and get into what I've got. People can't keep living like they're living and get what you got. Amen? Having a form of godliness and not denying the power of it ain't going to work. Men and women need the life of God. They need to be in the presence of a holy God. Amen. They need to let the purging power of the Holy Spirit work in them, convict them, bring them to Jesus, praise God. Rid them of their sin. Amen. Bring them into the light. Hallelujah. And it's not going to happen if all we ever do is run to the river to get our satisfaction and then go out and outlight the world. Well, I'm satisfied. That's not enough. I mean, if that's the case, you just need to go into heaven. That went over big. If all you're going to do down here is you be satisfied, not help the world go on to heaven. It's more satisfactory up there. You're called to be a river. You're called to let the rivers flow out of you. You're called to reach humanity. You're called to build the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. You're called to bring truth to the hurting hearts. Amen. And you don't bring truth by being like the world. You bring truth by being the light. Amen. Isaiah 10:27 says, "And it shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken off his neck, off his shoulder, the yoke off his neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing." I want you to know that in those rivers is the anointing of God. What difference can I make? You can make a big difference. The world is not interested in whether or not you can have a rock and roll style concert and call it worship. Sorry. Now, Christians may think it's the coolest thing since peanut butter and sliced bread. Since orange juice. We might think, "Woo, we had us a good time." But the world isn't going to reach what they need because you can do that. Come to my church. We got rock and worship. We got cooking worship. Yeah. But what else is going on there? Is there any anointing that destroys yokes and removes burdens? Are the captives being liberated? Are you going out into the highways and the byways satisfied from the well of life that springs up in you, but full of the Holy Ghost to be a river to humanity? Water on parched ground. Amen. Men and women in desperate need, and here you come with water. A river of water. Not just a barrel, not just a jug, not just a little bit, not a little Brill Cream style dabble, do you? But enough to satisfy. Enough to sustain. Are we going to be bearers and bringers of the rivers? Or are we just going to swim in the river and enjoy it? Yeah, it's okay. It's all right to get in the river and get blessed. But that's not why the river's there for you. Mainly. Let's just say mainly. It's got to be overly general. I won't overgeneralize. You are to take it to humanity. Our purpose is to reach the lost. Our purpose is to get them into the kingdom. I ain't got time to tell anybody about Jesus. I got to get over to the Holy Ghost meeting tonight. Why don't you get them saved and bring them to the Holy Ghost meeting? Why don't you be a river and then bring them? I was looking for some kind of amen crowd behind me. I need a choir. Kind of like the preacher's wife. Amen. Amen. You know, they get going about there. Yeah. Hallelujah. Look at Acts chapter 4, verse 29. We're going to finish up right here. I thought, you know, sometimes you think the services would go a different way. I thought this may go a different way, but it's not. But that's okay. Not important what I think anyway, is it? Acts 4:29, and now, Lord, behold their threatenings, and grant unto thy servants that with all boldness they may speak thy word, by stretching forth thine hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done by the name of thy holy child. What? Holy child Jesus. See, we get so excited about signs and wonders in the church when we're supposed to be having that out there. You're supposed to be having signs and wonders where you're going. Why? Because you're bringing the rivers. I said, you're bringing the rivers. They prayed. You know, they were threatened and charged the preacher, teach no more in the name of Jesus. They said, Lord, give us boldness. And not only that, stretch forth your hand. Amen? To heal. And signs and wonders may be done by the name of thy holy child Jesus. And when they prayed, the place was shaken where they were assembled together. They were filled with the Holy Ghost and spake the word of God with boldness. And when the multitude saw that they were of one heart and of one soul, neither said any of them aught of the things which he possessed was his own. They had all things in common. With great power gave the apostles witness of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. Notice that what happens when the rivers start flowing. With great power, witness of the resurrection is given. The key is that people come to see that Jesus is resurrected. Some of our churches still have him on the cross. He's not on the cross. He's on the throne. He's resurrected. And the Bible says when they prayed for boldness, they wanted signs and wonders in the name of the Holy Child Jesus, that God began to work and the signs and wonders were wrought, and with great power was the witness of the resurrection given. We try to do it in a church service all the time when God's wanting you to go out there and have church services out there. Really not church services, evangelistic crusades of your own. Many evangelistic crusades where the rivers are flowing. I said where the rivers are flowing. Where the rivers are flowing. That's why you're to stay full of the Holy Ghost. That's why you're to stay prayed up in the Holy Ghost. That's why you need to be praying in tongues and stay filled with the Spirit, praise God. Be not drunk with wine, but be filled with the Spirit, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, making melody in your heart to the Lord. Why? So there's rivers available. There's rivers available. There's rivers available, praise God. So that you're laying hands on the sick. Cap, the other week, he had that co-worker. We prayed over the prayer cloth, sent it. They didn't know what they believed. Yes, they believe. I don't even know what I believe. They didn't know if they were agnostic, atheist, unbeliever, semi-believer. Child had been diagnosed with cystic fibrosis, or they went back in to find the test out. They were suspected of cystic fibrosis. We prayed over prayer cloth, sent it. Cap got to work to give it to the lady and found out he forgot it. He went looking for some material, got some material, prayed over it himself, gave it to the woman, went to the doctor on Friday, came back with the test results, no cystic fibrosis. Well, praise God for the anointing on the ministry. You know, that can get off on you as an individual. You don't have, the pastor don't always have to get it done. And we thank God for the anointing that God uses, but I'm telling you, God's training you up so you can go do it. You're going to carry your rivers places I'll never go. I said the rivers you carry will go places I'll never go. Hallelujah. And God wants to use you. God wants the river to flow out of you. God wants it. I mean, God, he wants you at home, staying full, staying satisfied. Excuse me. He wants you satisfied, drinking out of, that, out of your own well of life that he gave you. And then go carry the rivers. Get full of the Holy Ghost and go carry the rivers. The rivers of anointing. Can you say amen? Amen.
We trust that you were blessed by the Word of God and the flow of the Spirit of God in this service. If you would like to contact us, please write us via email at office@fvc.org or using our mailing address, P.O. Box 7752, Greensboro, North Carolina, 27417. If you would like to contribute to our ministry, please go to our website at www.fvc.org and click on the Giving Online button. Thank you, and may God richly bless you for your giving.